Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I'm going to show you guys how you can create your own quotes for coffee mugs using your Cricut and vinyl. So let's go ahead and get started. Once you have decided what you want to write out, whether you found it on Pinterest or Google or something like that, you're simply going to go to text. Now I have imported two different fonts that we're using today. We're going to use Farm Market as well as Gingerly. I'm going to come up to this search bar here and type out farm, and then here is my first one. I'm going to go ahead and click it here, and now we're ready to type. I'm going to go ahead and type out everything that I'm using with this font because I can actually detach them later. So I'm going to go ahead and just type out everything that I'm using. So it's going to be "Don't test me, Karen." Now, keep in mind, if you guys find something that you really like, don't type it out the exact way that they have it, the exact font and things like that, because obviously plagiarism and things like that. So I've got those typed out. Let's move on to our second font. For the second one here, we have Gingerly, and I'm going to go ahead and type that out so we can find it, which is right here. This is another one of my favorite fonts, and I will have these linked down below. Now, I want to do the same thing that I did before. I'm going to go ahead and type out everything that I'm using with this font. So same thing, if I was using three different types of font, I would want to go ahead and type out everything at one time. Now you don't have to do it this way. This is just the way that I like to do it. So I'm going to go ahead and type this out here. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on it, and I want to actually align this to where it is centered. So I'm going to go to alignment and go to center. All right, so the next thing I want to actually do is bring in that line spacing. A lot of people don't realize about using line spacing, and a line spacing will make this look so much better. So we're going to go ahead and just hold down that down arrow button until I get it where I want it. So as you guys can see, that's looking a whole lot better. All right, so let's go ahead and move on over to our other font. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this one right here. Now for this one, we're going to go up here to advanced, and then I'm actually going to ungroup to lines. You can ungroup to letters or lines. And for this case, I want to ungroup to the lines. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and size these out because I don't want these all the exact same size. So I'm going to go ahead and size this one out nice and big, just like so. And then I'm just going to kind of center that up. I'm going to size this next one down just a little bit, like so. So I'm just kind of playing around with it. So if you know a design that you like, whether you found it on Pinterest or whatever, you could eyeball it and kind of have it next to you on another screen or on your phone. So you can really look at it and kind of figure out about how you like it, their style, if that's what you're looking for. So I'm just going to go ahead and size out my other one. I want it almost the same size as Don't, but maybe a little bit smaller. So I'm just figuring out because when I weld these together, this K is actually going to be attached to this E. So I'm just trying to figure out what looks best. So now I'm going to go ahead and bring in the other piece here. Now, once I'm happy with this, I'm going to kind of maybe size this down just a little bit. You can always play around with it until you are 100% happy with it. So I think I'm happy with this. Everything may look good. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and select everything, and then you can go ahead and hit weld. The reason why I'm hitting hit weld is because the fact that the K and the E is touching each other. So I want those to attach to one another. So if you didn't have that, you could just hit attach to where they'll cut in the same area. All right, so next up, I'm going to go ahead and bring in this mockup. You don't have to do this, but this is a mockup that you could bring in so you can visually see whether you're selling something or, you know, so that way it can be your display, or you want to visually look to see how would this look on a mug. I'm going to arrange this and move this forward so we can size it down and put it on this mug. There's tons of mug mockups to look for on the site. I'll have this link down below. So now I can visually look at it and say, I really love the way that this came out. I am ready to proceed forward and cut this design out. I highly recommend using mockups for things like this, not only for listing them on the site or selling them for advertisement. It's perfect for placement. All right, so now that we're happy with this, the next thing we need to do is size it. So, you know, I don't like to size until I'm happy with everything. We're happy, so now I'm going to size it. And I want to do 4 inches high, and then we'll just see what width that gives us. So I'll go ahead and click on the width here, and then it's going to give us this amount right here. And I'm happy with it. I think everything looks good. So once you're done with it, you're ready to send it over to your mat and cut it out. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.